Hello, welcome to the McGuffey's online tutor. Today's lesson comes from the McGuffey's fourth eclectic reader, the revised edition. Lesson 1, Perseverance. Lesson 1, Perseverance.
"Will you give my kite a lift?" said my little nephew to his sister, after trying in vain to make it fly by dragging it along the ground. Lucy very kindly took it up and threw it into the air, but her brother neglecting to run off at the same moment, the kite fell down again.
"Ah, now how awkward you are," said the little fellow. "It was your fault entirely," answered his sister. "Try again, children," said I. Lucy once more took up the kite, but now John was in too great a hurry. He ran off so suddenly that he twitched the kite out of her hand, and it fell flat as before.
"Well, who is to blame now?" asked Lucy.
"Try again," said I. They did, and with more care, but a side wind coming suddenly as Lucy let go the kite. It was blown against some shrubs, and the tail became entangled in a moment, leaving the poor kite hanging with its head downward.
"There, there," exclaimed John, "that comes of your throwing it all to one side."
"As if I could make the wind blow straight," said Lucy. In the meantime, I went to the kite's assistance, and having disengaged the long tail, I rolled it up, saying, "Come, children, there are too many trees here. Let us find a more open space, and then try again." We presently found a nice grass plot, at one side of which I took my stand. And all things being prepared, I tossed the kite up just a little. John ran off. It rose with all the dignity of a balloon, and promised a lofty flight. But John, delighted to find it pulling so hard at the string, stopped short to look upward and admire. The string slackened, the kite wavered, and the wind not being very favourable, down came the kite to the grass.
"Oh, John, you should not have stopped," said I. "However, try again."
"I won't try any more," replied he, rather sullenly. "It is of no use, you see. The kite won't fly, and I don't want to be plagued with it any longer."
"Oh, fie, my little man. Would you give up this sport after all the pains we have taken both to make and to fly the kite? A few disappointments ought not to discourage us. Come, I have wound up your string, and now try again." And he did try, and succeeded, for the kite was carried upward on the breeze as lightly as a feather. And when the string was all out, John stood in great delight, holding fast a stick and gazing on the kite, which now seemed like a little white speck in the blue sky.
"Look, look, aunt, how high it flies! It pulls like a team of horses, so that I can hardly hold it. I wish I had a mile of string. I am sure it would go to the end of it." After enjoying the sight as long as he pleased, little John proceeded to roll up the string slowly. And when the kite fell, he took it up with great glee, saying that it was not at all hurt and that it had behaved very well.
"Shall we come out tomorrow, aunt, after lessons, and try again?"
"I have no objection, my dear, if the weather is fine. And now, as we walk home, tell me what we have learned from your morning sport."
"I have learned to fly my kite properly."
"You may thank aunt for it, brother," said Lucy, "for you would have given it up long ago if she had not persuaded you to try again."
"Yes, dear children, I wish to teach you the value of perseverance, even when nothing more depends upon it than the flying of a kite. whenever you fail in your attempts to do any good thing, let your motto be, try again.
What a great story. Let's look at the definitions.
In defining words, that meaning is given which is appropriate to them in the connection in which they are used.
So our first one is entangled, twisted in, or disordered. Assistance, help, or aid. Our next word is disengaged. That is cleared or to set free. Grass plot, a space covered with grass. Dignity, majestic manner. Disappointments, failures or defeats of expectation. How about discourage? To take away courage. Glee, which is joy. How about the title of our lesson? Perseverance. Continuance in anything once begun. Motto. What is a motto? A motto is a short sentence or a word full of meaning. If at first you don't succeed, try again. That is a motto. A motto to live by. So, what is the subject of this lesson? Why was John discouraged in his attempts to fly his kite? Or, what did his aunt say to him? What may we learn from this? What should be our motto if we expect to be successful? Think about these questions. Answer these questions. Get a parent or guardian or even a friend. Read the lesson again and try to answer the questions as best as you can. And even if you like, come up with a motto. Or if you have a motto, say it. Now you know what a motto is. Make one up. Well, this is the end of our lesson, and I hope you visit us again at the McGuffey'sOnlineTutor.com. Peace be with you. See you soon.
Your own set of wings, with your feet on the ground, you're a bird in flight, with your fist holding tight to the string of your kite. Oh, let's go fly a kite. up to the highest height. Let's go fly a kite and send it soaring up through the atmosphere, up where the air is clear. Oh, let's go fly a kite.
A kite needs a proper tail, don't you think?
That's what I said, sir. Go fly a kite. No, sir, no. I don't mean you personally.
Let's go fly a kite up to the highest height. Let's go fly a kite and send it soaring up through the atmosphere, up where the air is clear.
When you send it flying up there, all at once you're lighter than air. You can dance on the breeze over houses and trees with your fist holding tight to the string of your kite.
Congratulate you. Capital bit of humor, wooden leg named Smith. Or Jones, whatever it was. Father died laughing.
Oh, I'm so sorry, sir.
Oh, no, nonsense. Nothing to be sorry about. Never seen him happier in his life. He left an opening for a new partner. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much indeed, sir.